Hare Krishna. So I'm thankful to all the devotees for continuously coming and hearing the nectar of Srimad Bhagavatam. So we have discussed till now, day one, the glories of Srimad Bhagavatam. In day two, we discussed about the Kunti Stuti, which were 26 shlokas from the Canto 1, Chapter 8. In day 3, we discussed about Jiva Stuti, the prayers done by the soul. Each and every soul has prayed into the womb of the mother, which is given in the Canto 3, Chapter 31, and there are 10 shlokas we chanted on that day. Yesterday we discussed about the Dhruva Stuti, which comes in Canto 4, Chapter 9, and there were 12 shlokas. And today we are going to discuss about the Prahlad Stuti, which is from Canto 7, Chapter 9, starting from the verse 8, and there are 43 shlokas. So the time is required lot. So we are not going to discuss all, but there's some important shlokas and the story of Prahlad and Narsingha. So we have Prahlad Maharaj already ready for today. Prahlad Maharaj ki! So Prahlad is there already. So we are going to discuss on this story. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskritya. Naram Chayeva Narottamam. Devim Saraswatim Vyasam. Tato Jayam Udhiraye. Nashta Prayeshu Abhadreshu. Nityam Bhagavat Sevaya. Bhagavati Uttam Shloke. Bhaktir Bhavati Nashtiki. Krishnaya Vasudevaya. Devaki Nandanaya cha. Nanda Gopa Kumaraya. Govindaya Namo Namaha. Namaha Pankajanabhaya. Namaha Pankajmaline. Namaha Pankaj Netraya. Namaste Pankajangri. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya. Prabhu Nityananda. Shri Advaita Gadadhara. Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Ram Ram Hare Hare. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prestaya Bhutale. श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी। नमस्ते सरस्वते देवे गौरवाणि प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश आरुणे। हरे कृष्ण। So, today we are going to discuss on Prahlad Charitra, the prayers of Prahlad Maharaj. So there are many stories which comes in Bhagavat Puran about Narsingha, and there is special Purana called Narsingha Puran, which also explains about many stories about Narsingha and Prahlad. Also comes in Padma Puran, the past life of Prahlad Maharaj. Who was Prahlad? How could he become Prahlad in this life? And stories also comes in Brahma Vaivarta Puran, from where the Narsingha Kavach has been taken. So there are many, many such pastimes given from the Padma Puran, Narsingha Puran, and Brahma Vaivarta Puran, and Srimad Bhagavatam Puran. So before entering into the pastimes of Prahlad Maharaj, we should understand that his father, you all know, will not go in detail, Hiranyakashipu. The word Hiranyakashipu means, Hiranya means comfort. Hiranya means the gold, and Kashipa means the comforts. The people, those who are always engrossed in getting some golds and opulences in their lives and the comforts, they are like Hiranyakashipus. So we all can check ourselves. We fall in which category, Hiranyakashipu or Prahlad? So before entering into the past tense, we need to establish the characters. There are two characters, Hiranyakashipu and Prahlad. Hiranya means gold, and Kashipu means comforts. The people, those who are only want comforts of their life, and those who only wants the money and the opulence, they are like Hiranyakashipu. And Prahlad means Arladete ipi Prahlad. Arlad means the Ananda Shakti of Krishna. Arladani Shakti, Radharani. One who is Prakashta Rupena Arladani, called as Prahlada. One who is always engrossed in how to please Krishna, how to chant the Krishna's name day and night, is called as Prahlada. Prahlad is also known as the Smarana Acharya, out of the Navada Bhakti, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Vadanam, Sakyam, Dasyam, Atmanivedanam. A 9 devotional process, out of which Shravanam Acharya is. Who is the Shravanam Acharya? Parikshit Maharaj. Parikshit heard the Bhagavatam for 7 days, 7 nights without asking for any water or prasadam. But we need so much of pizzas and all every day. 4 days has gone when Shukdev Goswami is speaking Shrimad Bhagavatam and Parikshit was hearing Bhagavatam. After 4 days, Shukdev Muni asked, Parikshit, do you need some water? Then Parikshit said, do not talk about water, because water is the cause of my curse. I was wandering into the forest. I reached to the hermitage of Shamik Rishi. Shamik Rishi was in meditation and I asked water, but Shamik Rishi did not give me water. He was in meditation. So I took a dead snake and wore around his neck. And when his son Shringi, who was only 12-11 year old, a small boy, came and he said, who did this to my father? I curse the biggest snake of the snake lineage, Takshak, who is a flying snake, a dragon. Have you seen in Chinese movies? Prabhuji must have. No. Dragon. So the dragon, they are the flying snakes. So that Takshak was a very great snake. He will come and he will burn into ashes, Parikshit Maharaj. So Parikshit says, Shukdev Muni, water was the cause of my curse. So do not talk about water. I am happy, thirsty. I can continue because I am getting the nectar of Srimad Bhagavatam. I do not need water anymore. And they continued. So the Shravanam Acharya was Parikshit and Kirtanam Acharya was Shukdev Goswami. 7 days, 7 nights, who can speak? I need so many medicines for my throat. Still, it is not working properly. But Shukdev Muni, 7 days, 7 nights, continuously speaking Srimad Bhagavatam. Nobody stood from there. Many, many great rishis sitting there. Shukdev Muni was the smallest and the youngest, 16-year-old. And who was listening? His father, Vedavyas, is listening Srimad Bhagavatam from his son, Shukdev Muni. Not only Vedavyas was listening Bhagavatam, Vedavyas' father, Parashar Muni, was also listening Bhagavatam. Not only Parashar Muni was listening Bhagavatam, Parashar's father, Shakti Rishi, was also hearing Bhagavatam. Not only Shakti Rishi was hearing Bhagavatam, Shakti's father Vashishtha Rishi was also hearing Bhagavatam from Shukdev Goswami. And that's why he became the Acharya of Kirtanam. When he speaks Srimad Bhagavatam, many, many great sages who are in the Swarga Loka, Pitra Loka, and Brahma Loka, and different places, Himalayas, they all understood the time has arrived when the nectar of Srimad Bhagavatam, Parikshit is going to hear from the mouth of Shukdev Goswami. Why Shukdev Goswami is on such a level? Because he was like, external world is zero for him. He was focused internally on Krishna consciousness. He was not even wearing clothes and people were shouting on him, oh, you are going without clothes, criticizing him. But nothing changed him. He was continuously in his Anurag, Krishna Anurag. He was always in the attachment of Krishna name, Krishna name. So nothing can like disturb him from his Krishna conscious path. Once when devotee came to Srila Prabhupada, I said, Srila Prabhupada, please guide me. And I come to temple, I see so many faults in devotees. And there are so much of problem in devotees. Somebody eats a lot, somebody talks a lot, and so many defaults in devotees. And I know that Vaishnava offense is the biggest hindrance in the path of bhakti. So how can I ignore looking at the faults of devotee? Srila Prabhupada said, okay, I give you one pot of water, fill. You have to keep on your head and go around the temple and find out what are the problems in the temple. He said, if I have to take care of the water pot, how can I look on the different places? Prabhupada says, yes, that's the important point. The water drop should not fall from the pots. He said, no, but I cannot focus on the two things at one time. Prabhupada, that's what I want to make you understand. That you are focusing on the faults, that's why it's a problem. If you focus on your Krishna consciousness, you will not even see what is the problem with any other person. You will always focus how you are developing Krishna consciousness. That's important. So Shukdev Goswami was like this. Shukdev Goswami and Vedavyas, they both were walking through a pond. And some young girls, they were bathing on the pond without clothes. And when Shukdev Goswami was going towards the Shukratal, the place where the Bhagavatam was spoken, near Haridwar. And Vedavyas is shouting, hey, my son, please listen to me. When Shukdev Goswami, young 16-year-old boy, without clothes, going through a pond where the young girls are bathing without clothes, it does not impact it. Girls were smoothly bathing. But when Vedavyas, the father of Shukdev Muni, very old Rishi, was written Puranas, scriptures, Upanishads, he was going, all the girls took their clothes and covered their body parts. Then Vedavyas became very surprised. My young boy was going and nobody took your clothes. But when I came, an old Rishi, you people are taking care of your body parts. Why? And then the girl said, that's the beauty of your son. We have wear clothes or we have not worn clothes. He was not disturbed. He was going in his Krishna Naam, Krishna Anurag. But when you were going, when we took the clothes, you observed that we are taking clothes or we are not taking clothes. It means your eyes are on us, but your son's eyes was not on us. Though they were on the same place. So what's important is, we say, na, the beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. How you see the world. If you have a negative thoughts, you will see the world as negative. If a positive thoughts, you see the world as positive. You wear a black glass, you will see the black things. You wear a green glass, you have green things. Now, let's do some activity here. If I ask devotees, everybody, you have to count. How many people have worn a black colored clothes? Can you count? Can you count number of people here wearing black color? Any number? Okay, 16. 16 people have wearing black clothes, though the theme was orange. So only Sita Rampur is following it complete orange. So you don't have a choice. Okay. So who said 16? Anyone who said 16? Mataji. Okay. While you are observing 16 black color, did you observe other colors also? Or you were already focusing only on black? Mainly black. So this is how, if we go with some presumption in our mind that I have to look for faults, then you only see faults. You can't see the good in someone. Because you were observing black, so you can't count only black. You are ignoring the orange, green, red, everything. And that's life. When you go with the perception that I have to count only the negative things, let's see how this Prashant Mukund Prabhu from India is doing. Let's check how many faults he has, what wrong he says, how brilliant he is or how tough he is, whatever, with the presumption. You will make everybody has a report card in their minds, giving numbers 20. I give 20 out of 100, 50, 60. But when you come to Krishna conscious path, we should do not give any report card to anyone. We are not the judges. Do not be judgmental. Just sit and enjoy the nectar of Srimad Bhagavatam without judging who is speaking. It's important what he is speaking, the speaker is speaking, is the nectar of Srimad Bhagavatam. What makes a difference who is speaking? So, but we choose our things, and that's why we always carry a report card. So the Prahlad Maharaj, this becomes the Smaranacharya. Sravanam is Parikshit and Kirtanam is Shukadev Goswami and Smaranam Acharya is Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad is in the Smaranam Acharya. He keeps remembering Krishna all the time. Never a day gone, never a minute gone when he is not chanting the name of the Krishna. How did it happen? So it's a story comes in Padma Puran that there was a Brahmin whose name was Vasu Sharma. He has 5 sons from his wife Sushila, and all the sons were very learned, good conduct, and devoid of their father. Whatever the father taught, they learned everything and they followed the path of Krishna consciousness. Except this fifth son, which was very notorious, and he was not ready to listen anything. The youngest son of this Brahmana, Vasu Sharma, his name was Vasudev. So Vasudev become attached to one prostitute of their area. The 4 sons of a Brahmin were in Brahminical qualities. But the 5th one was very notorious, attached to a prostitute girl. So one day, this prostitute was like an Apsara, very beautiful. And they both made a plan that we will meet behind an old castle. And we'll meet together and we'll love each other. They plan. So this Vasudev, the son of Vasu Sharma, the 5th youngest son, he was waiting for the girl with some flowers in his hand. But the girl came late. So they had a quarrel among them. Both of them started fighting and throwing pebbles on each other. But Vasudev was carrying flowers in his hand waiting for the girl. And he thrown flowers on his face. And when he thrown flowers, the flowers fall on ground. And when the flowers were there, so he was brooming the floor of that area. And both of them did not talk to each other. And both of them turned aside, cried and slept at that night. In the night, there came an earthquake. And both of them died on the same place. When both died, this Vasudev, because unknowingly, he kept the fasting of Narsingha Chaturdasi. That was the day of Narsingha Chaturdasi. Unknowingly, he broomed the floor of that temple and the old castle having a Narsingha deity below the floor area. So he broomed, means he served Narsingha. When he was crying, the tears were pouring Narsingha. And he was fasting whole night, not taken a single food, because he was waiting that we will enjoy together. But the girl did not turn up. So this is how Padma Puran says, Veshakasya Chaturdasyam Shuklayam Sri Narakesari Jatastat Asayam Tat Puja Sarvam Kurvita Sarvatam Prahlad Kleshanasaya Yahi Punyaha Chaturdasihi Pujate Tatra Yatendraha Hare Prahladam Agataha. So Padma Puran and the Agams are mentioning Prahlad Kleshanasaha. All the bad sins done by the Vasudev, that son, all eradicated by the fasting of Chaturdasi, Narsingha Chaturdasi, day of the appearance of Lord Narsingha. And then in next life, this Vasudev gone into the womb of Kayadu Mata. And because he was demonic in his last life, that's why he took birth in a Asur Kula, demonic family. But because he worshipped Narsingha unknowingly, he became the follower of Lord Vishnu, Lord Narsingha. Sometimes devotee says that first time Narsingha appeared for Prahlad. But it's not like that. If it's like that, how come in Padma Puran's mentioning, Pujyate Tatra Yatendriya Hare Prahladam Agatha, worshipping Krishna in the form of Narsingha, Narsingha Chaturdashi, he become Prahlad in next life. It means Narsingha was already there, deity was there, temples were there. And Narsingha is in eternal form in Vaikuntha. He just appeared for Prahlad again because Prahlad was continuously chanting the name of Narsingha. Because his attachment was with Narsingha from the past life. And that's why Hiranyakashipu and Kayadu. So the Kayadu was the daughter of Nagaloka. So how come this Kayadu, not a demonic lady, but a demigod. So in Nagaloka, this Kayadu was residing and Hiranyakashipu was capturing all the above planets, Swargaloka, Brahmaloka, and was tormenting, torturing all the demigods, Indra, Varuna, Chandra. And he used to catch them and bring in his jail, in his prison house, and kept all the demigods were locked in his jail. So he went to lower side of the planetary system, he went to this Nagaloka and he said, I will kill all the Nagas. I will kill everyone. The Nagaloka people prayed, please leave us. So I can leave you only on one thing. If you make your daughter marry me, she's very beautiful. They said, okay, you can marry. So the Kayadu was a blessed girl. What the blessing she had? She had a blessing that she can carry any womb for any number of time. Like it's not necessary to deliver a baby after 9 months, 10 months. She can keep it for many years, ages. And that's why we need to understand the intricacy of Bhagavatam. How could the Prahlad was given into the conceivement before the Hiranyakashipu went for 100 years of tapasya? And that 100 years is not like us. It's divine, celestial 100 years. Means there one day is our 1 year. Multiply how much years has passed away. So how could this Kayadu carrying the Prahlad in the womb? Because she is a Naga Kanya. She has the blessings that she can carry the womb for a longer number of times. So the two answers now we have got. So how come Prahlad, the soul Prahlad, entered the womb of Kayadu? So the Hiranyakashipu was a demonic king and he was capturing all the demigods, giving so much of pain to everyone. And he became very against to Vishnu because Vishnu is a killer of his brother Hiranyaksha. He said, I will kill Vishnu one day. I'm not going to worship Krishna or Vishnu. So he said, I will go and I will please Brahma. So he went for a tapasya in one Himalayan mountains. When he went for tapasya, the two rishis, Narada Muni and Parvat Muni, they said, if he did tapasya, and he become an austere person, one day he will kill every living entity. So we have to do something. We have to stop all this nonsense happening in this Asur Kula. We have to bring some devotee in the family. So that one devotee can change and deliver the 21 generations. So we have to do something. So Narad Muni and Parvat Muni took a form of a bird. And they went into the mountains and Hiranyakashipu went for a tapasya. Standing on one leg, folding hands like a Dhruva, we did yesterday. And chanting, Om Brahmaya Namaha, Om Brahmaya Namaha, Om Brahmaya Namaha. Where he was chanting his mantra, Narad Muni and Parvat Muni imitating in bird's form, Narayana, Narayana, Narayana. And they are disturbing. And that only four alphabet word Narayana, changing the mind of Hiranyakashipu. What's this? Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudeva. No. Om Brahmaya Nama. Then they are Narayana, Narayana. Like we go for this chanting Harinam Sankirtan. Day before yesterday, we were there in the Hyde Park. Saurabh was there doing kirtans. So when we go out and do kirtans, though demonic people are all around, but this holy name when entered, it disturbs them. And all their sins eradicates and they become Krishna Guru devotees. It takes time. But yes, we create cracks on the minds of those people. Though they may not come that a single day, but later on 20, 10 years, 15 years, one day they will realize, yes, I heard somewhere. The cracks we create. So we should create cracks in the minds of people by giving Hare Krishna, Hare So this was done by Narad Muni and the Parvat Muni. Hiranyakashipu said, this is not a right time, not a Shubha Muhurat for tapasya. I should go back and enjoy my wife. Material people, when they become frustrated, they think that sex enjoyment can give them a better relief. So he came back and he asked his wife, Oh Kayadu, come on. I want to remove my frustration coming in my mind. But in mind, what is there? Narayana. Narayana, Narayana. And Kayadu says, what happened to you? He said, I don't know. I went for tapasya. But there were two birds disturbing me. I tried to kill them, but they vanished. They flew away. But they gave this name, which is my enemy's name. Narayana, 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 Narayana. So his consciousness became Narayana conscious. And with this consciousness, when he did union with the wife, the semen was carrying the soul which is required to be a family in the womb where the bhakti can continue. So that Vasudev from the past life entered into the demonic family, but because he did Narsingha, tapasya in the last life, in this life, the consciousness of the father become Narayan conscious and the Mata from the Nagakanya Loka is also the austere lady. So the soul entered into the womb of Kayadu. Next day he went for tapasya. Narad Muni and Parvat Muni was happy that we have already sown a seed of a devotee in the womb of Kayadu. But the Indra was very like against this. Indra said, how come? Later on, if he become a devotee, not instead of devotee, he become a demon. Like it is a question of the devotee parents also. In the very beginning, the children behave like a devotees. But when they grow up 16 years of age, though their name is Krishna, but parents never expected that he will do the Krishna Leela. And basically, after 16, they do Rasa Leela. So, when we imitate Rasa Leela, we are actually doing the Rascal Leela. We can't imitate Krishna Leela. Krishna is God and we are not God. So, but if you create a sanskaras, sanskar, you know what the meaning of sanskar? Sanskar, though in Sanskrit, means the purificatory processes. But if you abbreviate, break it into two pieces. Sun means the child and scar means a scar on the body. If you have a scar on your body, even you grow old, 70, 80 year old, but the scar will remain on your body. So create such scars on the memories of your children that they remain whole life on their brains, memories. And that just by bringing in the Bhagavad Gathas, bringing in the Harinam Sankirtans. Though when they become 16, 18, 20 year old, they might deviate, but later on, those scars will make them U-turn when they get frustration from the material world. there is the only hope that they will come to Krishna consciousness. So we have to just sow the seeds, and you have done your task. Like Parvat Muni, Narad Muni did the task, sowing the seed, and they said, when time will come, we will be happy, there will be devotee. Though he born in a asura family, all the deviation, all the material world education, no problem. We have sown the seed. So the seed was sown. Indra said, later on, he will become powerful like Hiranyakashipu. We have to kill the Vansha, Parampara of Hiranyakashipu. So the Narad Muni again said, no. We are developing a devotee in the womb of Kayadu. We have to take care of her. Then Narad Muni took that Kayadu to his ashram and taught Srimad Bhagavatam Katha. So the Prahlad heard Srimad Bhagavatam in the womb of his mother. And continuously for, not only for 9 months or 10 months, 100 celestial years. When Hiranyakashipu was doing tapasya, multiply, 100 celestial means thousands of years. How could the Kayadu keep the womb pregnancy for so many years? Because she was Nagakanya, having a special boon that she can keep the womb as it is for many millions of years. So when Hiranyakashipu came back, Narad Muni know that now that his tapasya is over, he has requested Brahma to bless him with mortality. I will never die. Brahma said, what to talk about you? I also die. If I also die, how can I give you immortality? I can't give you that blessing. He said, okay, do some amendments in my blessing. Human cannot kill me. Animal cannot kill you. I should not be killed by any astra or shastra. Astra means when you hold and shastra when you throw. I should not be killed by astra or shastra. I should not be killed by any time factor, day or night. I should not be killed inside the palace, outside the palace. I should not be killed by any weapon. I should not be killed either on the earth or neither in the sky. I should not be killed in the 12 months. He created, like, planned such a nicely that nobody can kill him. Either animal can kill or human can kill. Either you will be killed in the sky on a plane crash, or you will be on a road accident. Either you will be killed inside, death come, either outside. Either in the 12 months, either by the astra or shastra. So he planned in such a manner, nobody can kill me. Yes. We also plan like this. Security system, this system, insurance, health insurance. Nobody can kill me. But death is inevitable. Inevitable. Death will arrive. So he planned like this. And Hiranyakashipu, after getting the blessings, Brahma says, Evamastu, this will happen to you. Go back. He become very happy. Now he's more fearless. More fearless. Going here and there. Then finally, Narad Muni telling this story to Yudhishthir Maharaj. And Narad Muni's devotee, like disciple, was Prahlad. First time, Guruji explaining about his disciple. Maximum time we see that disciples glorify their Guruji. Spiritual masters. First time spiritual master Narad Muni glorifying the disciple Prahlad to Yudhishthir Maharaj. Yudhishthir, you know, don't know what kind of austerities Prahlad has done. So we need to become such a disciples that our spiritual masters, our senior Vaishnavas, they glorify you. You need to do such kind of service. Bhakti Siddhant Maharaj used to say, the guru of Srila Prabhupada, do not try to see Krishna. But serve Krishna in a way that Krishna wants to see you. Who has done this service? Amazing service. Who is doing it? We always try to see Krishna without doing any service. We have to see that we have to serve. How we can serve? So we have to see that only Sitaram Prabhu should not take care of the temple. But all the devotees should take care of the temple. They should think that it's our temple. It's not Srila Prabhupada and few management people temple. It is of the every living entity, it's a temple. When you serve Krishna day and night, then Krishna will come to your home to see you. Who has done the cleaning? Who has cooked the food? Who has done the dressing? I'm not seeing that fellow. So it happens with many devotees. There is one Mataji in this area called Karoli. So there are deities of Sanatan Goswami, Radha Madan Mohan. So Madan Mohan is very reciprocating vigraha. And Madan Mohan is a Sambandha vigraha in our lineage of Gaudiya Vaishnavism. If you want to have a relationship with Krishna, the first comes Sambandha Gyan, then comes Abhidhya Gyan, and then comes prayojana. So Madan Mohan is sambandha vigraha. So you have to establish a relationship with Krishna, then should first start with Madan Mohan's darshan. So that lady, one lady used to give milk every morning to Madan Mohan temple. She was a cowherd woman. So used to give milk into the temple. And Madan Mohan used to have a breakfast every morning with the milk, prasadam. Very nice. Few days gone and she suffered with some disease and she could not come to the temple. Madan Mohan was so much like habitual of drinking milk from the woman who used to boil milk with some cardamom, some groundnuts and some almonds, some cashew nuts. Beautiful milk used to be given every morning to Madan Mohan. And Madan Mohan used to wait when this milk will come. And finally, when she was in disease, 3-4 days gone, Madan Mohan was missing that milk. And one day Madan Mohan went to the house of that lady, a coward. It does not depend how many number of hours you are chanting. It depends when you are chanting, how much your quality, how much your faith is into Krishna consciousness. Maybe you are chanting the whole day, but you don't have a faith on Krishna. Then what's the use of chanting? If your faith is Krishna is the ultimate provider, ultimate protector, ultimate enjoyer, then definitely even your one Krishna name can give you so much of blessings. Special blessings. So this is how this lady surprised to see Madan Mohan in the house. Oh Madan Mohan, from where did you came? He said, I was missing your milk, the ground nuts, the dry fruits and the cardamom. I was missing that. She said, okay, just you sit here, I bring this milk. And the night she started like boiling the milk, preparing the milk with ground nuts and dry fruits and all. And Krishna drank all the milk. And later on, what happened? That Krishna forgot his chadar. Krishna wears the chadar and many this kind of chadars. So Krishna forgot that chadar, yellow color garment, at the house of that coward woman. He said, time has gone. I came at 2, but now it's already 4. It's the time of Mangal Arati. Devotees will be waiting for me. I have to go back. She said, no. Please stay for long more. I want to see you. I'm diseased. I cannot come. Don't worry. I will come every day 2 p.m., 2 a.m. in the night. But today let me go. Devotees are waiting at Mangal Arati. So Krishna comes every day Mangal Arati. You may not come, but Krishna comes. Krishna comes to see how many devotees comes. And then Krishna sees, oh, people are at their home enjoying, relishing blankets. So Krishna feels bad every morning. So Krishna went to the Madan Mohan temple for seeing his devotees. But the pujaris were disturbed. Whereas yesterday, whilst making the Krishna sleep, we gave so many garments. Where is that yellow color of our chadar? It's missing. Where it's gone? Looking for. Then somebody said, I have seen that garment. While I was coming from the village, I saw that cowherd woman having one chadar, yellow color, dazzling from her hut. So she has stolen. So all the pujaris went and took a big sticks and started beating. And Krishna did not came to protect. When so much of pain was given to the woman, she cried, oh Madan Mohan, you yourself came for drinking the milk and I gave you the milk and still I have to be bitten by those people, those pujaris. Krishna says, yes, it's an old tactic of mine. In Vrindavan, many people used to beat me just for the milk. So you want to be my disciple, you have to take a training. I need a trained disciples. No problem. I will give you all the ailments, all kind of medicines I will provide. And then Krishna was talking again to that lady. So it was happening 3-4 times. So they said, Pujari's plan, we have to make this woman out of the village. Then only things can be, otherwise she will become a thief. She will steal all the golden ornaments. We know her planning. So everybody became against her. So one day all the pujaris coming for Mangal Arati. So they are opening the altar, the temple's door. The temple door was not opening. And they tried all the padlock, this lock, all the keys, password, but nothing happening. They tried breaking the gate. But that gate was also not breaking. So then Madan Mohan said to the head pujari, "It will not open for the people who do offenses towards my devotees. It will not open. Even if you open that altar, you will not see me. If you want to see me, first of all, you have to go back and pay obeisances to my devotee and say, 'I am really sorry for that.'" So they said, "Okay, what next we have to do?" And not only pay obeisances, because you have given so much of pain to that lady, now bring one palki, one palanquin. Make her sit on the palanquin. And when you will come, without lock, the altar will open, the gate will open of the temple. They all went to the dead lady, said, "Sorry, sorry, we are so sorry. Come sit on the palanquin." And when she sat on the palanquin, they all came to the temple. They found the temple door open automatically. So that's Krishna's taking care of all devotees. All devotees. Do not think Krishna is not seeing you. He is just a marble or a wooden or a metal deity. He knows what's happening in our life. He knows each and everyone. Each and everyone. So there are so many pastimes like this. So Narad Muni is explaining to Yudhishthira about his own disciple Prahlada. Shri Narada Uvacha Porohitaya Bhagavan Vritte Vritte Kavaya Kilasure Shand Amarako Sutatasya Detya Raja Grihantike. Narad Muni said the demon Hiranyakashipu accepted Shukracharya as his guru, the guru of demons, as their priest for ritualistic ceremonies. And Shukracharya's two son and Amarak, lived near the Hiranyakashipu's palace, was given for Prahlad teachings. Take this Prahlad and teach him how to be a good murderer, how to kidnap women, how to not follow, what to be done, what not to be done. Tell him everything. How to become a big demon in the entire universe. And take him to the best demonic university. Make him admit. Whatever donation required, I will pay. But make him admit in the best demonic university. I want to make him a best demon. Sandamarak, the son of Shukracharya, said, "Yes, Maharaj. Yes, Maharaj, we'll do. As you said, we'll do. They took Prahlad, 5 years old, admitted in a school, and they both started teaching. How to murder? First of all, take out your sword like this and go nearby and then shout. So this training been given to demons. So like we say, na, Hare Krishna, pay obeisances. They also play. Go and punch and say, that's their planning training. So Sandamarak training, and Prahlad was saying, no. Not do like this. We have to chant the name of Vishnu. Because Hiranyakashipu, while conceiving, took the name of Vishnu, and the child at the 5 year of age chanting the name of Vishnu. That's called Garbhadhan Sanskar. It's not just that we meet Mary and when the child is there, then now we are training. So you can't train. One man came to me in my temple and said, smoking cigarette, "Prabhu, how early he can learn Bhagavad Gita?" I said, "Prabhu, how early you can leave this cigarette? Once you leave the cigarette, he will pick Bhagavad Gita. Because parents are the role model of the children." Devotees say, "Prabhuji, my child is not understanding Gita, is not behaving like a devotee." Actually, parents in the temple, they are very good. Rest you know. When they go back, they are not parents. They are husband, wife, and they are fighting together. And children keep watching a tennis match. Ball will fall in which court? And they like, tick, 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 tick. And they get training. Ah, good, good, good. Very nice. So that's why, if you behave properly together in your family, the children will develop a quality. Yes, my mama and papa are real devotees. Devotional life is very good. No fighting, nothing. Peaceful life. But when you fight, they said, what's the big deal of chanting Hare Krishna? Still they are fighting together. So that's give a wrong impression on the minds of the children actually. So we have to be a good, like good role models for our children. Don't chant even for Krishna Prem, at least for your children Krishna Prem. So this is how Prahlad learned everything, but he spoke only Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Namo Narayana. Namo Narayana. Namo Narayana. Akhil Brahmandaya. Namo Narayana. Oh, Sanya and Amrak, the two teachers, they said, what are you speaking? Your father will kill us. He's a very dangerous person, you don't know. He said, I know my father. He's not such dangerous, he's good. But why are you saying so? You know, should not speak Vishnu's name. Do not say these mantras. Learn how to become a good demon. How to, they say, hoo ha ha ha. No, you speak like this. And they were training and he was against. And then the report card, after first phase of the, like here in 3 years, you go for examination. After 3 years of examination, this examination time came, parents teacher meeting, PTM, parents meeting the teachers. Hiranyakashipu is a parent and teachers with Sandamrug, they are meeting, PTM is going on. What's about the progress of my child? Did he learn? No, sir. He is chanting your enemy's name. Vishnu's name, Narayan, 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 in our school. Not only he's chanting, when we go for lunch break, when we come, we find all the demonic children. He take everyone and they all dance together. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Rama, Rama, Hare Hare. Hiranyakashipu said, oh, we have to take care of him. If he behave like this, kill him. I don't need a child who is favorable to my enemy. Kill him. He said, okay, we'll do so. Prahlad did not change. And slowly, gradually, Sand and Amrak becoming against Prahlad. And said, oh, what should be done? And they put a stone in the legs of Prahlad and thrown from a top hill into an ocean. And he will dip and drown. Yes, we have done the task. Finally, thing has been completed now. And they were standing on the shore of the ocean. They found out that Prahlad is swimming on the top of the ocean. The stone weight is also out of his body. How did it happen? Prahlad says, I do not know my Guru Maharaj, Sandanamrak. I do not know. But I know that this ocean is my Nana's place. My maternal grandfather's place. It's my Nana's place. Then Sandama says, how come it's your Nana's place? You don't know. When the churning of the ocean happened, Samudra Manthan, at that time, Lakshmiji came out of the ocean. And she is my mother because the consort of Vishnu. She is my mother. And mother comes from the Nana's or Nani's womb. So this becomes my Nana's place. So how come the Nana can kill the son of the daughter? So that's why it's my family place. Oh, that's the reason. Then they reported Hiranyakashipu. Oh! Then do something else. Put him in the cage of snakes. There should be many snakes. They will bite him. Rattle, cobra. Throw him. And Sandamrak take that boy. Thrown into the snake's pond. Pond of snakes. And Prahlad was, oh, such a beautiful snakes. They have got a neck like Krishna's color. Because bluish color. Oh, there's Sham Varna. Yashamvan, remembering seeing the black color of snake, remembering Krishna. What he will do if snake comes? All will run away, leaving Bhagavatam class. Huh? What to talk about snake? Even the cockroach comes. Half of the Matajis will be out. Though we learn that Bhagavatam makes fearless, fearless, fearless. When the time, test time comes, this shows how much we are fearless, actually. Huh? So it happens. We are in the chanting procedure that at any emergency time, the Harinam should come out of our mouth. even in the accident situations, skhalitova, if anybody against you, anybody criticizes you, you should not change your language. It should be like Hare Krishna should comes out of your mouth. Hare Krishna should comes out of your mouth. Some devotees were traveling with me to Vrindavan Dham. Shishi Gaur Nitai ki. So some devotees were traveling with me to Vrindavan Dham. And everybody was carrying bead bag in their hands. And they had a good class how to be fearless, continuously chanting the holy name. And they all were Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram. And we people, when we preach, we become happy that everybody is chanting, having faith on Krishna. So we went to a place called Chausat Samadhi, 64 Samadhis of the Gaudiya Vaishnava Acharyas. So in one Samadhi and another Samadhi, there is a gap of like 50 meter or 20 meter gap. So there's red stones. In summers, they become very red hot. So from one Samadhi, they paid obeisances and going to other Samadhi, there's a hot marble, hot stones you have to walk through. So all were barefoot walking. So they paid Srila Sanatana Goswami ki jai. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. Hare Ram, Ram. Then again to Srila Gopal Bhatta Goswami ki jai. Hare Krishna, they're doing it. Then suddenly from after 3-4 Samadhi, there's a gap of 100 meter of stones, right? Very hot. Then we all were walking, some were running. That's okay, the chanting. But few devotees carrying the bead bag in their hand and then, they forget on Hare Krishna. So when the emergency situation arises, if you're going in a car and some animal comes in between, what you say? Oh shit! And just imagine if it were your last words. Antkale cha mameva. Where you will go? Krishna will say, Yam yam vapi smaran bhavam. Tyajanti antkale varam. You were, that was destined for you that you will die in an accident. And when some animal came, you pressed the brakes and you said, oh shit! And immediately your soul transferred to a stool in the warm stool. And you take shit. And somebody will say, Mama! You will reach to Mama. So this is how Antakal is very important. When we click a picture of someone, your makeup is done very nicely, foundations and creams and eyeliners and Mataji's hair bags and everything. Prabhuji is putting tilak, chadars, and now they're ready. Ready for clicking! Haribol! Click! And suddenly, a fly comes and sits on the nose of someone. And for removing that, he said, do like this. So last click point, the picture will come. That what the foot picture is like this. Similarly, when Krishna at the last time, Antakale, he clicks the picture. What is in your memory? And whatever is in your memory, that you will carry forward into next life. You will get immediately. The girl sitting here, they have remembered in the last life the girl. The boy sitting here, they have remembered the boys in the last life. So, if you remember your son in last life, you will become a male. If you remember a Mataji, you will become female. A wife, female. Husband, male. And what about if you remember dog at your last life? Oh my sweet two. Then, oh! Then you can't do anything. So one person was asking, Prabhuji, if I have done many pious karmas in this life, many pious, I have given so much of donations, charity. I am not a good devotee, but I am a good person who is contributing to society so much. And if I remember my dog at last time, what a big deal. I said, no problem. You will enter in a dog body, but in an opulent family because you have done good karma. So you will sit near AC air conditions. So you will get a good family, good home. You will reside there. Some dogs are on the streets, dying for food, starving. Because they remembered the dog in the last time. but they did not did charity also, so they are starving. One who did charity and remember dog becomes dog, but in a good opulent family. So whatever you remember at last life, and how can you check? Because after last time, you cannot, there is no scope for improvement. But you can check while you are cutting these vegetables and you cut your fingers, what comes into your mouth? Oh my God, or oh Krishna, or oh shit, oh mama, ouch, ooh, ah, ouch. So what comes from your mouth? And you know, if you chant the name of Krishna, practice should be like this, that even in such situations, when you take the name of Krishna, that will definitely bless you with more number of mercy than normally when we chant Hare Krishna sitting in the AC conditioned room. That's written in the Shastras, that if somebody patitam skhalito bhagna sandrashtaha tapta ahata hari iti avashenaha aha pumanana arhati yatanaha patitaha. If you are falling, skhalito, if you are slipping, bhagna, if your bones breaking, fractured, sandrashtaha, if there is a cut in your finger or your body, taptaha, if you are in a fever, high disease, ahata, if you have a wound in your body, and hari iti avashen aha, if you chant the name of Hari at the time, pomanan arhati yatanaha, you will never enter the narka loka, hellish planets, because you have chanted the name of Hari at that time, and that will give you multiple blessings of the holy name, because you chanted at the emergency time. So if you can chant at that time, then you can remember the last time also. If you, it's a practice, you can check when you have a fever, disease, what you chant. Please save me, please save me, please save me, or you chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna. What is your faith? So this is how Prahlad was thrown into the snake's pond, but he was seeing Krishna in the snake's area also. Then said, he said in the snake area also, that's okay, no problem. Put the elephant leg on his face and the elephant will kill him. Elephant is such a big, but a small boy, 5-year-old, kill him. Elephant also did not kill him. Nobody is killing him. Last, they said, okay, give him poison. Poison, and he will die soon. When he drank the poison laughingly, smilingly, and in that situation also, Prahlad, remembering Krishna, Smarana Acharya, remembering Krishna, Krishna, Namo Narayan, Namo Narayan. He drank poison. Poison could not kill Prahlad. How did it happen? That poison cannot kill. Then they asked, poison is also not killing you. How come? He said, because he is my Mamaji, my maternal uncle. How come? Because when Lakshmiji become my mother, ocean become my Nana, and from the ocean comes the halahal poison, and the Mamaji comes from the same womb. So Mamaji, the halahal, my Mamaji. So how can my maternal uncle can kill me? So I am saved by my maternal uncle. Nobody was killing. Then finally, they said, okay, the demoness, Holika, the Buaji of Prahlad, auntie, she said, okay, I have a special chadar. I will wear that chadar and I will make the Prahlad sit on the fire pyre. And there was a demonic party was going on. All the demons were happy. So today we will drink, eat non-veg, and we'll see a special item number, and there Prahlad will be burnt to ashes. Oh, Haribol! Posters were placed all over. Prahlad on fire, Prahlad on fire. WhatsApp messages sent. Theme was black color. Everybody was happily enjoying partying. And finally the stage performance in the auditorium happening. Very good bow. Wooden fire was created, and the Holika, whose original name is Simmika, Simmika demoness, she sat down on the fire pyre and made the Prahlad sit on the lap. And finally, slowly, gradually, the fire improved, increased, 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 and she was wearing that chadar of given by Brahma, the blessings of the Brahma. That you cannot burn into ashes if you are wearing this chadar, special blanket. Then how could she burn and Prahlad saved? And Acharya says, Brahma's boon was working. She was not burned by the blanket, but she was saved by the blanket. But later on, Krishna become against the demoness who is hurting the Vaishnava. So when you do some offense, then Sudarshan Chakra's Agni burns you. Sudarshan Chakra. So Sudarshan Chakra is an automatic mode. Need not to play the button. It's an auto mode. The moment you do offense, Sudarshan Chakra starts coming on your hand. And start burning you. And you will say, I'm not feeling good nowadays. I'm not feeling happy. I'm going to temple, Prabhu. I'm not feeling happy. I'm feeling like people don't love me. I'm alone. Devotees are cheaters. They are not behaving good. This is all happening because you did some offense and Sudarshan Chakra is burning your spiritual life. Still Sudarshan Chakra comes. Do not think. Do not laugh. Sudarshan Chakra comes. But in a subtle form. So this is how Sudarshan Chakra burned that lady, demoness Simmika. And later on Prahlad was saved. Demon friends asked, Prahlad, how were you feeling when you were on fire? He said, fire, I was feeling very cool, atmosphere. Fire was outside, but inside, I was remembering my Lord Vishnu. Namo Narayana, Namo, Namo, Namo. So this is how he was continuously doing and remembering Krishna. So there is a special bhajan we'll sing. How could the Parla save Krishna, protect his devotees? Play Mridanga. Jisko tera bharosa, jisko tera sahara, jisko tera bharosa, जिसको तेरा सहारा, जिसको तेरा भरोसा, जिसको तेरा सहारा, जिसको तेरा भरोसा, जिसको तेरा सहारा, जिसको तेरा भरोसा, मझदार क्या करेगा, मझदार ही किनारा, मझदार क्या करेगा, मझधार ही किनारा, जिसको तेरा भरोसा, जिसको तेरा सहारा, तेरी कृपा से मोहन भक्तों की नाव चलती, तेरी कृपा से मोहन भक्तों की नाव, तूफान हो या आंधी उनको तो राह मिलती, तूफान हो या आंधी उनको तो राह मिलती, हाँ जिसको तेरा सहारा, जिसको तेरा भरोसा, तो पे नाम तेरा तुल में उमंग तेरी, तो पे नाम तेरा दिल में उमंग तेरी, अलमास राह में छाई तरंग तेरी, रोशन है काली रातें पाकर के तेरा सहारा, रोशन है काली रातें पाकर तेरा सहारा, जिसको तेरा
छूटने न दे प्रभु हाथ जिसका पकड़े कभी छूटने न दे अपने गले लगा कर हर जख्म भर दे अपने गले लगा कर हर जख्म भर दे है दयालु भक्तों का रखवाला इसको तेरा भरोसा इसको तेरा सहारा हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण राम हरे राम हरे राम राम हरे 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 कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे राम हम राम हरे
एवरीबॉडी हरे कृष्ण हरि बोल
गोविंदा बोलो हरि गोपाल बोलो राधा रमन हरि गोविंद बोलो श्री राधा रमन हरि गोविंद बोलो हाँ गोविंद बोलो हरि गोपाल बोलो गोविंद बोलो हरि गोपाल बोलो श्री राधा रमन हरि गोविंद बोलो हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
गोविंद
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे हरे राम राम हरे 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 कृष्णा
हरि बोल
लास्ट टाइम हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 राम
This is how Prahlad was saved again and again, again and again. And then finally, when nobody could kill Prahlad, Hiranyakashipu said, I will take this case in my hands directly. please bring the file, open the case. Case was open. I will do the final closing of ceremony today. It's the closing ceremony. Prahlad, what do you think about yourself? Where is your Vishnu? He is hiding. He does not come in front of me. Prahlad said, he does not come in front of demons. I have never seen him. How you can see? Demons cannot see Krishna. Demons cannot see Krishna. Once one person was in Mayapur and arguing with Srila Prabhupada, Swamiji, where is Krishna? I have never seen God. You people are asking money to build temples and this. Have you ever seen God? Srila Prabhupada said, yes, he is available. Everybody can see. Where is God? Can you show me? Yes, I can show you. Okay, are you feeling thirsty? He said, yes. Take some water. You take a sip of water. Did you see Krishna? I said, no. That's why you are a demon. You can't see Krishna. Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, raso apyamasya kantve, I am the taste of the water. And if you can't taste the water and see Krishna in the taste, it means you are a demon. And for demons, Krishna does not come with Shankha Chakra Kamal Gada. He will not come. For demons like you. Swamiji, why are you saying like this? Why are you saying like this? Oh, you are demon people. Chant Hare Krishna, become a proper candidate for Krishna consciousness, and then later on Krishna will appear in front of devotees. It will take time. It's a procedure to follow. For every demon, Krishna is not free. That you just bring the bell and Krishna is available for you. It's not like that. And then Hiranyakashipu said, okay, I will take care of him. Bring him and make this sit on the lap. Where is the Vishnu? Where is the Vishnu? What are you talking, father? Asura varyam dehina. You are the king of the demons. He did not say demon directly. He said, you are the king. Whenever you want to criticize someone, criticize in a very, very proper manner. So, he said, Asur Varyam Dehinam, you are the king, you are the Asur Varyam, you are the best of the demons, you are the best. And he becomes, ha ha, ah, finally you accepted, I am the best one. Yes. Where is the Vishnu? Is he anywhere? Yes, father, he is every single atom of your palace. His name is Vishnu, means who is available in the Vishwa ke har anu mein jo virajman hai. His name is Vishnu. He is in the every single atom, that's why his name is Vishnu. Oh, really? He's in my palace, hiding from me. Where is he? Bring in front of me. You can go anywhere. Okay. So now, already things were planned and he took out his sword in his hand. Said, he's in this wall? Yes. He's in this wall? Yes. Is he in this pillar also? Pillar of the palace? And the Narsingha was there in the pillar of the palace. Already planned. Already available. Hiranyakashipu planned Narsingha there. So how did Narsingha came out of a pillar? If I ask you, Narsingha is there in this wall? What do you say? Yes or no? Shall we break? Siddharam Prabhu will say, after hard work I made one wall. Prabhu, you came from India, make the wall fallen. So, is he here or not? In this temple, Narsingha is there or not? Will he come for you or not? No. She belongs to Hiranyakashipu family. Okay. Narsingha was not hiding inside. Like Narsingha and Prahlad has a role play to do. Like Mataji is doing drama party. Na? They make a thermocol pillar and one Narsingha hides inside and then Prahlad, okay, done. And then lights are there, people are standing, and then Hiranyakashipu, hoo ha ha ha, he comes and breaks the pillar and then Narsingha comes out. We do in drama, but do you know that Prahlad said, yes, he is there. He was not knowing Narsingha is there or not, but he said, yes, I have a faith, Prahlad. Prahlad said, yes, Narsingha is there. Hiranyakashipu said, okay, if he is there, and I will break the pillar and let's see if Vishnu appears or not. So what happened? Sri Narada Muni said, Satyam vidhatum nijabhratya bhashitam vyaptim cha bhuteshu akhaleshu cha atmanaha Adrishya atatta putro rupam udvavam स्तंभे सभाया न मृगम न मनुषम. विल चैंट वन मोर टाइम. दिस मंत्र इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड. सत्यम विधातुम निज भ्रात भाषितम. व्याप्तिम च भूतेषु अखिलेषु च आत्मना. अदृश्यतात अदभूत रूपम मधुहन. स्तंभे सभायम न मृगम न मनुष्यम. स्तंभे स्तंभे इन द पिलर. स्तंभ मीन्स पिलर. सभायम मीन्स विद इन द असेंबली. सभा एंड मेनी डीमंस, थाउजेंड्स ऑफ डीमंस वर लुकिंग. महाराज हिरण्यकश्यप विल डूइंग सम मिरेकल एंड टुडे प्रह्लाद्स गेम इज ओवर एंड ऑल द डीमंस वर वेरी रेडी टू सी द शो. अ फर्स्ट डे फर्स्ट शो स्पेशल मूवी. एंड वॉट हैपन ऑल द डेमिगॉड्स इन द स्वर्ग लोक आर ऑल्सो लुकिंग वॉट विल हैपन. डज टुडे हिरण्यकश्यप एंड और प्रह्लाद विल बी एंड वॉट विल हैपन. दे आर लुकिंग पीपिंग फ्रॉम द स्वर्ग लोक. From the Patal Loka, people are looking upwards. Different seats in the cinema hall. Some are lower, some are upwards. So different angles, people are looking this show. And carrying the flowers in their hands. And what happened? The moment the pillar was broken. So how the Narsingha came inside? Satyam vidhatum nija bhratya bhashitam. It's very important verse. Because my bhratya, my servant Prahlad, has said that Narsingha is in the pillar to fulfill the words of my devotees. Krishna Narad says Narsingha appeared from the pillar to fulfill the devotees' words. If I say in this mobile Narsingha is there, if I am a pure devotee, Narsingha will come out of the mobile. And if I am not a pure devotee, you keep trying at your home. If Narsingha comes from mobile phone, so it means you are pure devotees. Does not come, then you have to work more. And satyam vidhatum nij bhrakta bhashitam vyaptim cha bhuteshu akhleshu cha atmana. And everybody was seeing adrashya adbhut rupam. This roop never ever seen by the demons in their life. Because of Prahlad, one devotee, whole congregation of the demonic people looking Narsingha. But their characters did not change by seeing God. People have a habit of going to temple, but just by going temple, you can't become devotee. Because all the demons seen Narsingha, but they did not become devotees. So just by going temple does not solve the purpose of being into the human life. You have to become a surrendered devotee of Krishna, chanting the holy name, clean your heart. So all the demons, they were looking, what is this? And Narsingha is roaring like a lion. Oh, I will kill you. You are giving so much of trouble to my devotee. Today you are gone. Hiranyakashipu is fighting. All the demigods are looking. And now Narsingha is playing like father plays with a child. Punches, and when child punches, father says, ah! Similarly, Narsingha thrown his club on the head of Hiranyakashipu. He fall down, rolled, and then he took his club and came with full power force and then hit on Narsingha. Narsingha says, ah! And fall back. And the demigods become fearful. Oh, Narsingha, you are getting hit by Hiranyakashipu. He's powerful. What will happen? Their sweating is coming on their face. Oh, what is happening? What is happening? They are praying. Oh, Narsingha, please kill, please kill, please kill. And this game was going on. Again, he brings, holds, and again loses. Narsingha holds and then loses. Narsingha holds and then loses. Oh, hold! Ah, he's gone. Then lose. Oh. When batsmen hits the ball and then people say, oh, four or not out. Similarly, it was out, not out. So all the demigods were looking at amazing matches going on. And all the demons were ready with their swords and everything. And Narsingha Dev only said, and in one way, more than 1 lakh soldiers, demonic soldiers, they all gone into ashes, all were killed. In one roaring of Narsingha Dev. And how big was Narsingha? Narsingha was big that his Narsingha's hair, the lion hair, they were waving into the clouds. That was the height of Narsingha. A lion, a half man, half lion, with the long ears into the clouds. Red eyes and big teeth and tongue out with a roaring sound and with big nails. And he held Hiranyakashipu. And all the demons already killed, Hiranyakashipu was trying to get out of his clutches, but finally he held. And Narsingha said, "What did you imagine that you will not be killed by anyone? What Brahma can give you blessing? No demigod has the power to give any blessing. If I do not permit Anumanta, Anudrashta, I provide the permissions. You ask that I should not, you should not be killed either in the outside of the palace, inside of the palace. I am killing you, Hiranyakashipu, on the between, in and out, on the main door of your palace. It's not in, it's not out. You ask that you not be killed in the sky, not in the ground. I am killing you on my knees. It is not sky, neither is the ground. You said you not be killed by a weapon, astra shastra. I am killing you with my nails. You said you not be killed by animal or a man. I am half man, half lion. For you, I have done a special makeup. And now I am killing you finally. And you said I should not be killed out of the 12 months. Oh, Hiranyakashipu, I have created another month, 13th month, called as Purushottam month, Adhik Mas. Once in 3 years it comes, additional, out of the 12 months, 13 months. So that 13th month created by Krishna for Narsingha Dev. Okay? Huh? Okay. Now for Hiranyakashipu, Narsingha created. And then finally, the first open surgery done without anesthesia. No anesthesia given, and open surgery was done. And Narsingha opened his stomach and took out the intestine out of the body. Said, when somebody comes, we have to make the garland wear to the devotee. But I, Lord, coming in your palace, you are not giving me garlands. He took out intestine out of it and wore around his neck. Thank you, Hiranyakashipu. When some devotees come, we give water to the devotees so that they can drink. So what? You have not given me a single water glass. So I will, what lion drinks? Blood. So he took out the blood from the stomach of Hiranyakashipu and drank. Thank you, Hiranyakashipu. And then finally, he took the heart out and started flying into the air. And when 1, 2, 3 and punch, and then it is pressed, completely gone the heart. I have given the place heart so that devotees can make me stay in their hearts. But you have kept lust, greed, anger in your heart. Oh, I have to clean and throwing like this in the air and then finally punched out, pressed. All the heart is changed. Complete surgery was done. Purificatory process. Full purification was done. And then he was thrown into the ground. And then still Narsingha was in lot of fear, very angry mood. And he was roaring like anything. He will eat up the whole universe. Lord Shiva, Brahma, everybody was ready to pacify Lord Narsingha. And they were standing in a queue, like in temple you have a queue of darshan queue. They were in queue, standing out, that we'll pacify. So, there is a chapter in this Canto 7, where every demigod, not only Shiva, Brahma, Indra, Chandra, Varuna, Pitra, Gandharva, Naga, Loga, and everybody was there. All the demigods came and they were looking what Narsingha will reply. So Narsingha in anger mood look at Brahma. Oh Brahma, you gave the blessing, na? I will take you later on, I will check. I gave you the power to bless devotees, you are blessing demons. Oh. Then Brahma said, it's not right time to meet Narsingha. He took a U-turn and go back to the queue. I will go later on. Then Shiva came forward and Shiva did a stuti, Rudra prayers. And then Narsingha again looked in very angry mood to Shiva. You are Vaishnavanam Yatham Shambhu. You are the best among the Vaishnavas. I sent you on earth planet to maintain and help my Vaishnavas. Vaishnava Prahlad is in pain and you are meditating on me. You should have helped. You should have helped the Prahlad. So Shivji began thought it's not right time. He also went back. And then Lakshmiji was standing back and every demigod said, why don't you go? Because husbands has a habit of listening to women only. And you are Mataji. Mother, you can also only tell Prabhuji what to be done. It should be quiet now. Case is finished. Mataji was, makeup was done. New dress was given. And Lakshmiji in a very, very femalely posture started moving toward Narsingha. Oh, Narsingha. And find Narsingha. Like, and she became fearful and fell back. She said, I will not go. This is not right time to talk to husband. Lakshmi is teaching, when your husband is in angry mode, do not talk. Do not talk. Lakshmiji fall back. All the demigods says, wow, if he is not listening to Lakshmiji also, now it's out of the box. Nobody will control, able to pacify. Finally, they ask Prahlad, it's all happening because of you. Why don't you go and try? Prahlad said, okay, let me try. Then all the demigods asked Prahlad, but if you will go, you are not fearful of Narsingha. Then Prahlad replied, why I should be fearful? In the forest area, all the animals are fearful of lions, tigers. But the tiger's child, the pups, the cubs, are they fearful of the lion? No, because they are their son, their daughter, their children. Similarly, I am the children, I am the child of Narsingha, lion Narsingha. So why should be fearful? And the moment Prahlad reached to Narsingha, Narsingha became very happy. Narsingha put his Vardhasta, his hand is called as Vardhasta of Narsingha. He put the Vardhasta on the head of Prahlad. A very big hands with all nails coming out, and he put on the head of Prahlad. Oh Prahlad, you are such a nice boy. And just by touching of the Narsingha's hand on the head of Prahlad, all the Vedic wisdom appeared in the head of Prahlad. Prahlad became the most knowledgeable person. Gyani Bhakta. He became the Gyani Bhakta. And all the knowledge appeared in his mind. And he started doing prayers which are called as Prahlad Stuti. He paid obeisances and did many stutis, which comes in 7th canto. Chapter 9, verse number 6 to 50. There are 43 shlokas of Prahlada Stuti. So we will not take all because time is short. We'll take 3-4 stutis. What Prahlada said to Lord Narsingha. So this is the first one we are chanting. Sorry, from 8th verse. In 6th, Prahlada was touched by the Narsingha. And from 8th shloka, Prahlada is chanting the mantra. Prahlada Maharaj prayed. श्री प्रहलाद उवाच ब्रह्मादये सुरगणामयो मनो मुनो योथा सिद्धः सात्विकतान गतयो वाचां सप्रवाहे नराधितुं पुरो गुणेरधुनापि विप्रो किं तुष्टं मरति समे हरिर् उग्रजाते किं तुष्टं मरति समे हरिर् उग्रजाते Prahlad said, Brahma Adaya, you are headed by Brahma. Brahma was first in the queue. Surgana, many other devotees were standing in the line. Munayo, many saintly persons are in the line. Ataha, Siddhaye, Siddhas are standing in the line. Sattvaha, many spiritual people are standing in the line. Ekant Gateha, who has taken without diversion into the material activities your shelter. Vachamsa and Pravahe. Aradhitum punha puru gunehe, and they are fully qualified to do the prayers. Brahma can do the prayer, Shiva can do the prayer, Siddhas can do the prayer. They are fully qualified because they are your devotees. But what about me? Kim tushtam api? How can I satisfy you, Narsingha? Harir ugrajate, because I have taken a birth in a demonic family. Ugrajate. I am born in a ugrajate. This is the humility of Prahlad Maharaj. Though Narsingha is very happy from Prahlad. Prahlad is saying, I am the fallen one. Though if Brahma did prayer, he took a U-turn, Shiva could not do the prayer. They are fully surrendered. They are meant for prayers only. Rudra Stuti, Brahma Samhita, They are not doing prayer. I am born in a Ugra Jati. How can I make you satisfied? That's the humble attitude of Prahlad. That we need to develop on ourselves. And then Prahlad further said to Narsingha that, oh Narsingha, I want to say that Brahmins, if had 12 qualities of a pure Brahmin, but not surrender to Krishna, is lower than the Chandala. Vipra dvishat gunayutat arvindanabha padarvindam ukha shapacham varishtam. If somebody is in a Brahmin family and not developed the 12 qualities of a Brahmana, guna, he is no more a Brahmana. He is lower than a chandal, eating the dog's meat. So do not become egoistic by taking birth in a Brahmin family. We need to become Brahmin by the qualities. Shama, dama, tapa, shaucham. Shantir, arjavam, evachaha. Jnanam, vijnanam, astikyam. Brahma, karma, subhavajam. Krishna says in Gita, chapter 18, that you all need to develop these qualities. Then you can be called as a Brahmana. Very tolerant in nature. Very peaceful in nature. Very surrendered in nature. Worshipping Krishna. So, Prahlad Maharaj said, oh God, I know I am not a Brahmin. I am Asura. How can I do the prayer? I am not a Brahmin. I am not a Siddha. I am not a Brahma. I am not a Shiva. How will I do the prayer? So, Krishna says, I do not need anybody's service. I just need the faith behind the service. The faith behind the service. The bhav behind the service. How you are serving. That faith is required. Then Prahlad said, I just want to be association of your devotees. Nij brat parshum. What you can give me, I just need that you bless me. I should have the devotee association. Because I am seeing you only by the blessing of Narad Muni. He remembered his Guru Maharaj. This is a teaching. Even if you meet Krishna, first you need to thank your guru that now you have achieved Krishna. But people forget their teachers. And that's called ungrateful people. They learn from so many people. Even if you have learned, like if you learn something in a harmonium mridanga, so you pay obeisances to your teachers. And in Indian community, we have a culture of touching our ears before we take the guru's name. I'm really sorry. If I do any mistake in notations, music, they touch their ears. But in devotional life, people come, learn Sanskrit, learn Gita, learn Bhagavad. And then when they become leaders, seniors, they forget their gurus. From the whom they learned. And they say, from the birth, I am like this. From the womb, I was speaking Gita shlokas. You learn, you heard now, go on my YouTube channel, you will find. And I am from the womb I was chanting Gita shlokas. There was one person, he was sitting on a pond side. And on the pond's shore, he saw a special bird come from the top and takes the fish in the beak and then flies again. So the bird is coming. And this fellow was not having any job, any work, sitting on the shore of the river and saw this. He said, it's nice that birds comes like this. And then turns like this, holds the fish and then flies. Wow! What a special things to be learned. So that fellow learned everything and starting doing circus items. He made one bow like this, what do you call it? Boomerang. He made one boomerang very sharp from a wood. And then he used to throw into the air and then the boomerang when comes, he holds with his mouth. Because he learned from that bird. And many people used to watch this from giving the donations, charity. Oh, what a fee, what an item, what a wonderful circus. Used to throw and then learn, throw and hold from the mouth. Later when he grown, a lot of people used to come to see him. He became very popular. Then he thought, why to do from wooden? I should make the iron ones. He made very sharp blade kind of a boomerang. Thrown and holds. People used to say, wow, amazing, amazing. He's holding from the teeth. Oh, what a catch. What amazing. One day one reporter came and said, it's amazing. We want to cover you, your whole biography. How did you learn? From where did you learn? So please tell us, from where did you learn this technique of holding from the mouth? He said, from the birth, I am like that. Our reporter said, really? You are a talented person. Huh? You are the America's most talent. So we will take you on a show. And then the show was there after the report was done. And he thrown it into the air. And this time, that boomerang came and cut his neck and he was dead. Because he has forgotten, ungrateful to his spiritual masters. So when you grow, when you learn, when people respect you, do not forget, every respect is not yours. It's your spiritual masters. So if you remember this, you can grow like Prahlad. After meeting Narsingha, Lord Shiva, Lord Brahma, everybody is hiding behind. He has reached. What better devotee can be like this, who is meeting God and sitting in the lap of God, and he is saying, oh, I just need the blessing of my spiritual master. Nij bhratya parshvam. I need the blessing of my spiritual master. Why? Kutraha ashishaha shruti sakha mrigatrishna rupa kva idam kalevaram asheshru jambiroho. No happiness, nothing can be get. It's like Mrug Krishna, mirage in the world. What is mirage? When you drive on roads, you will find there is water on the road. When you reach near, there is no water on the road. When you are in desert area, you go finding for the water, you will find there is a water pond. When you go close, there is no water. It's called Mrug Krishna. And the deer die in from the mirage formation. Kutra Ashisha Shruti Sakha Mrut Krishna Rupa. How will I get the Ashish without the devotee like Narad Muni? If he will not bless me, I could not have get you. So I need his blessings. I need my spiritual master. I need devotees. I don't need you, God. Because of them, I am getting you. And if I forget them, you will go away. Then how will I associate? And how will you come again? So most important is the devotional association. Te prasada ta seva anurupam. Because of the service I have done to my spiritual master. Because of his blessings, because he has given me standards, I am seeing you. So my desire is, if you want to bless me, that I want to serve my Siksha Guru before you. Tava Bhritta Sevam in the shloka number 28. If you will go, you will find it's written. I want to serve first my spiritual master. Go into the verse number 28. We will read all together this verse. Then nothing this Prahlad said. Evam janam nipatati pravahai kupe. Kama bhikama manuya pratapa prasanga. Kratavatma sata surashanam bhagavan grihita. So aham katham nu vraseje tava bratya sevam. My dear Lord, O Supreme Personality of Godhead, because of my association with material desires, one after another, I was gradually falling into the blind well full of snakes, following the general populace. But your servant Narad Muni kindly accepted me as his disciple and instructed me how to achieve the transcendental position. Therefore, my first duty is to serve him. Please tell me, how could I serve him? From God is asking, how can I serve my Guru Maharaj? Devotees ask Guru Maharaj, how can I serve Krishna? So we are oppositely doing what Prahlad did actually. We should ask Krishna, how can I serve my Guru? How can I serve my Vaishnavas? And we ask God, how can I serve my spiritual master? And we should ask from spiritual, we should not ask from social master, how should I serve Krishna? Though spiritual master teaches us how to serve. But our prime priority, Prahlad is saying, my first duty is to ask how to serve him. Let me know, Narsingha. That's the beauty of the Prahlad's prayers. Prahlad did this. And he's saying that I was gradually falling into the blind well of full of snakes. So this graha, grahitam andhakupam, this family life is like a blind well. Have you seen the blind well? How the blind well does not have water. It only has snakes inside. So this family is like a blind well. No water means no enjoyment. Only the snakes bites the family people, bites each other. He got only the poison. And that's why even the family people keep wishing another. I want to give you wish. I want to give you wish. Wish you happy birthday. Wish you happy anniversary. Wish you happy Diwali. Wish. So much of wish. And actually, but they do not want to give you any wish. They do not want to pray for you. If somebody says, I pray for you that this Deepavali, this new year brings happiness to you. And by your prayer, if happiness comes to him on January, you are the first person who feel bad. How could he be happy? By your prayers. Oh, my prayers are working. They are not working for me only. For you it's working. So if you wish, I wish you could get a big car with bungalow, lot of money. I pray this new year you will be healthy. In January he calls back to his friend. Oh Prabhu, by your prayers I got a big car, big bungalow, good health, good money. Oh, shut the phone. I will talk to you later. He become envious. Though his prayers, so what kind of wish we are giving each other? Many WhatsApp messages wishing you happy Diwali, wishing you happy New Year, wishing you happy birthday. But actually we don't wish for anybody's birthday happy. We wish only gives poison. We are envious of everybody's success. I should only be the successful. How could this devotee be successful? How could be he happy? I should be happy only. So this is not a good scenario. We should serve. Tandera charan sevi bhakt sane vas. Janam hai ehi abhilas. Tandera charan sevi bhakt sane vas. जन्म होए एही अभिलाष जन्म होए एही अभिलाष एचे गोसाई जब ब्रज कैला वास राधा कृष्ण नित्य लीला करिला प्रकाश आनंद बोलो हरि भज वृंदावन श्री गुरु वैष्णव मजाइय मन श्री गुरु वैष्णव पद पद्म करी आस नाम संकीर्तन करे नरोत्तम दास हरिहराय नम कृष्णाय दवाय नम केशवाय नमः गोपाल गोविंद राम श्री मधुसूदन गिरधारी गोपीनाथ मदन मोहन श्री चैतन्य नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत सीता हरि गुरु वैष्णव भगवत गीता श्री रूप सनातन भट्ट रघुनाथ श्री जीव गोपाल भट्ट दास रघुनाथ
चेई को साई करे चरण मनाना जा होई ते विघ्न नाश अभिष्ट पुराण इचे को साई जारा मुई तार दास तासा बारा पदरेणु मोरा पंचग्रास तांदेरा सरण सेवी भक्त सरे वास जनमे जनमे एई अभिलाष
This kind of prayers for the Vaishnavas. We should have these prayers instead of becoming jealous, envious. Prahlad is saying, what's the use of this? We should pray for every devotee that they should be happy and I should be the last one. Prahlad in his whole lifetime cultivated 72,000 demons. Demon children he cultivated 72,000. His congregation preaching was very strong. 72,000 demon children were cultivated by Narsingha Puran says. 72 demons converted to Vaishnava community. All started chanting this Hare Krishna mantra. That's just see the power of Prahlad at the age of 5. And when Lord Narsingha said, what do you want from me? You need anything? And Prahlad said, I am not a businessman. For my prayers, I do not want anything in return. If there is a want, then there is no mercy. If there is want, there is no mercy. If there is a want, there is no peace. People say, we want peace in our life. I want peace. So how will you achieve peace? Know that? Do you know that? Just write in your paper, I want peace. Now cut two words to achieve the word peace. Which are the two words you have to cut? I want. So if you cut in your life, I am something. And if you cut the wants, I want this from God. Then what will remain? Why we are unpeaceful? Because of we have I and we have want. We'll keep saying whole life, I want peace, I want peace, I want peace. God will say, remove I, remove want, you are peaceful. We are not peaceful because we have so many wants, desires, so many I's, egos. Remove this I and want. Prahlad is saying, so I do not want anything. If I want, then I am a businessman. I am a Vanik Dharmi. I am not a businessman. I am your servant. Still Narsingha said, ask me anything if you want. You have done so much. You have gone through a troublesome situation. What do you want? Let me know. Okay, Narsingha, if you want to bless me, then bless me that I should have no desires in my life. This blessing I want. No desires. If you come to Gaur Nithai Darshan, should ask, Gaur Nithai, please bless me, so that I should have no desires in my life. But we come with so many list of desires. So what's the use of that? Though it's written that we can come to Krishna for all our demands also, but that's not pure devotional, that is mixed devotional service. It's Mishrit Bhakti, not a Shuddha Bhakti. If you want to go on Shuddha Bhakti platform, achieving and relishing the Krishna Prem, then you should not have any demands in your life. Krishna will fulfill automatically whatever you have, whatever you want, whatever you need. He is Father. He knows what to be given to whom to at what time. Krishna knows. Then again third time Narsingha said, any other thing you want? Okay, if you want again and again you are saying, just let me know that can you purify my father? Though he was a demon, but he was my father. Again the tinge of attachment was there. Then Narsingha said, Kuru Tvam Preta Krityani Pitu Putasya Sarvashaha Mat Anga Sparshena Anga Lokanyasta Supujaye Kuru Tvam Preta Krityani. You do the final ceremony of your father. Shraddha, Pindadana. Sometimes devotees ask, is it required for devotees also? You can check 7th canto, chapter 10, verse number 22. Narasingha Lord is saying to Prahlad, Karu tvam pret krityani. Do all the kritya of your father. Though pitu putasya sarvashaha, because father is already purified, mat angena sparshena, because I have touched him, he is purified, but still is there. I am chanting Hare Krishna, do I need to do the Shraddh Karma, Pitra Puja I need to do? You do not need to do Pitra Puja, keeping a picture of your Pitras at home and doing aartis. No, you do not need to do that. This is Pitra Karma, means in 1 year, when the Pitra Paksha come, and the day when your ancestor left the world, offer food, cooked food, feed Vaishnavas or cows. That's a activity to be done. It's a natural. Asked by Narasingha, Prahlad, you do. Pret krityani, though mat angir sparshena, because of my touch, your father is purified. Still, you have to do. So, people, those who ask question, where it is written, why to follow, you follow Bhagavatam. If you will not follow Bhagavatam, then what a kind of devotee you are? Keep asking questions, whole life will go away. Because it is written. Yasti suprajaha, he will be good citizen in the next loka. He will not fall into narka. Now people think, Narasingha said, Tri saptabhi pita putaha pitra bhi sahate annadha sata sadho asya kule jata bhavan vekulha pavanaha. Oh Prahlad, what to talk about your father? Tri saptabhi pita putaha pitra bhi sahet annadha. 5, 7 on your father's side, 7 on your mother's side, and 7 coming in your generations. These 21 generations purified by one devotee in the family. If you chant nicely Hare Krishna and do all the things written for Krishna consciousness, you will liberate 21 generations. 7 on your father's side, father, grandfather, great-grandfather, great-great-grandfather, great-great-great-grandfather, great-great-great-grandfather. Mother's side, mother, mother's father, maternal grandfather, then maternal great-grandfather, maternal great-great-grandfather. Then when you will marry, you will have son, son's son, grandson, great-grandson, great-great-grandson. You will purify all by one chanting of the holy name. But this does not mean that everybody will enter Vaikuntha Loka. So Krishna, Narasingha is not saying that he will enter Vaikuntha Loka. Lokani yasya suprajaha, he will take birth in a loka where he will not fall into the hellish conditions. Means he will enter into Swarga Loka. But Vaikuntha entry is only by chanting of the holy name. So we can liberate our ancestors only by chanting that they will not fall into hellish planets. They will not fall into hellish planets. But for that, you need to be sincere devotee. They are sincere devotees. Strict devotees, they are many devotees, very strict, they are sincere devotees. So you need to be strict, sincere, serving Krishna consciousness and very strongly following it. Then Narasingha said in 23rd verse, after cremation of your father, kindly sit on the throne and fix your mind on me and do your duties as per the Vedas. So Narasingha never said, now you have become a devotee, no duties on your shoulders. People are fearful. If my son become devotee, my husband become devotee, then who will do the duty? The duty or devotee? Devotee will do the duty. And devotee will do the duty in a more better way. Because he will think this duty is given by Krishna to me. Otherwise, if you don't do this duties, then devotee is not good. Then devotee is like running away, escapist from these responsibilities. Till the time you don't enter into sannyas ashram, if you are grasta or whichever ashram you are, you have to do your prescribed duties as per the Vedas, Shastras, not for sense enjoyment, but for serving Krishna, keeping the Krishna in the center of your home. Then becomes duties, prescribed duties, and devotees do like this. Then Prahlad said that this is good, Krishna, I will take care, I will become the king in place of my father Hiranyakashipu. I will sit on the throne. And this all discussion going on, sitting on the throne of Hiranyakashipu. Sometimes devotees ask that Hiranyakashipu was a demon. How could Narasingha, the purified form, when we install deities, only the Brahmin initiated devotees can go and touch. How come Narasingha deity sat on the throne where the Hiranyakashipu was sitting, it was dirty place. No Achmandan, no purificatory Om, Pavitram, Apavitram, Tarvam, Avastam, nothing was done. Still, he is sitting, nursing as if. Why? Because Hiranyakashipu is the father of Prahlad. Because Prahlad is a devotee, and that's why Narasingha accepted him also as a father, liberate him. And also the second thing, because while Hiranyakashipu was sitting on the thorn, he made Prahlad sit on his lap. So that seat, the thorn, was touched by Prahlad, and Krishna warned the dust of the lotus feet of his devotees. Krishna warned the dust of the lotus feet of devotees, and we warned the lotus feet of Krishna. That's the competition between devotee and Krishna. So we need to be very sincere. Krishna wants us to become a pure devotees, but we are delaying in becoming pure devotees. We are mixed devotional service with so many demands, desires. What will happen? How much miser you are, but you have to give everything one day. Though you will not give your life, you will not give your time, you will not give your money to Krishna now, but one day will come when Krishna, Harishyami Aham Sarvam, at the time of death, he will take away everything. So what's better? Voluntarily give or Krishna take it forcefully? Voluntarily we should give. There was one person, he was very miser. So he used to stay in Rajasthan, and he was a baniya of Rajasthan. And he was used to spend not even a single penny in any worshipping, anywhere. He used to steal from people and not used to spend anywhere. One day he went to Mathura, and on the Yamuna he was going to take a dip in Yamuna. So there are many Brahmanas on the Yamuna river banks, you have seen. They used to say, okay, you are my jajaman, and I will chant some purificatory mantras, you pay me some dakshina. Then this fellow said, I am very miser, I will not take dip in Yamuna, that's okay, but I will not give you single penny. Then the Brahman said, oh, no problem, you take dip, I will write in my account book, and when time arrives, you come and then you give later on a credit note, I am taking 1 rupee from you. At that era, only 1 rupee was sufficient. 1 rupee in the Indian currency. 1 rupee, just imagine. So, he wrote down 1 rupee, he chanted mantras. Om Yamuna Snanam Pavitram Karishyami. All the mantras chanted. He said, okay, thank you Maharaj, thank you. He went back to Rajasthan. This fellow, who was Yamuna's Panditji, Yamuna's Purohit, he said, already 10 days have gone, he has not given any single penny, returned back, I should go and ask for my 1 rupee. He reached to Rajasthan. His wife asked, who are you? He said, I am Panditji Purohit, came from Yamuna riverside, and I want to come and I want to have my 1 rupee back as a dakshina, pending dakshina. Otherwise, he will fall into hellish planets. He has to give Brahmin's money, should give. She went inside and asked, that Brahmin came from Mathura, are you going to give? He said, tell him that I am deceased, I cannot walk, I cannot talk, I am in a very deceaseful condition. She came out and said, he is suffering a lot. Since the time he returned back, he can't give you any single penny. He is in a very tough situation, he is completely deceased. Then that fellow said, Panditji, okay, I will go inside and check, because he is my client, he is my jajaman, I have to go inside and serve him. He's in a problematic situation. So he went, he was forcing to come inside, and she again went back. She said, he is coming inside, what should we say? He said, go back and say he's dead now, he is gone, so what is the use of coming inside? For 1 rupee, he said, I am such a situation. Then the Panditji was also not a very simple person. He said, no problem. Because he was my client, it's my responsibility to do the last crematory activities. Then she came inside and she said, he is ready to do the cremation. Then this fellow, this Vanik Baniya, said, no problem. You call the cremation ground people, bring my pyre, I will lie down. And when I will go, he will see that I have gone to the cremation ground, he will go back. So then the cremation was started, and then the pyre was meant, and he lied down with closing his eyes, holding the breath, and everybody started chanting, Ram Nam Sat, Hari Nam Sat, Ram Nam Sat. the pyre was going and Panditji was going behind. And with one eye he was looking, Panditji is there or not. Panditji reached till the crematory ground. And the body was kept on the wooden pyre. And ready to fire, the sun was there. Panditji was thinking, what a person he is. For 1 rupee he is ready to burn himself. But he is not ready to give even 1 rupee. So miser person, never seen. So there are two types of people. One are kanjus and second are makkichus. Kanjus people are those who don't give money to anyone. And makkichus are those, if makki falls in the milk, they take out makki first and then take the milk out of the makki, mosquito or that fly, and then drink the milk. Means they cannot give to someone, even they don't invest on them. They live in very miser conditions, miserable. And they have crores of rupees in their banks. They are called as makkichusas. So that makkichus was there, ready to burn. Then Panditji become compassionate. So Panditji said, I am Vaishnava, Karuna Sindhu. I will help him out. I have one mantra which can make him alive. Son said, really Panditji, my father can come back to life? Yes. One mantra is there. Okay, then do it. Why are you not doing it? Panditji said, I was waiting. But no problem, I will chant the mantra into his ears. And fire was ready. He was ready to burn. Suddenly he chanted, do not worry, come to life. I will not take 1 rupee. And that fellow came up to life. Came up to life. And Panditji was also not a simple person. He came up to life. And all the boys started thanking Panditji, because of you, my father is back into life. What a Vedic mantra you chanted. Such a nice mantra you chanted. Thank you so much. What can we do for you? He said, give my 1 rupee back. So that fellow was very miser. Panditji was following up like this. So the material world is like this. Either you give or the creation will take by force. Once I asked one friend of mine when I was in a corporate sector. I was not a full-time devotee. I was working outside. And I was started coming to Krishna conscious temples and preachings a little bit. So I asked one devotee on Janmashtami day, give some donation to Krishna. What is the use of the money? This will go in vain. One day, this money can't save you from death. Lakhs and lakhs of rupees can't give you oxygen. Lakhs and lakhs of rupees can't give you life. Give it to Krishna. Krishna will save you, protect you. He said, okay, I will give. So he was ready to give 5,000 rupees at that time in 2004 or 5. 5,000 rupees he planned. He counted. He said, I will give 5,000. I was happy, yes. Finally, I was able to cultivate one devotee for donation. He was ready to give. But suddenly his wife was also working in the same company. She came and said, no. Don't give to Krishna. Weekend is coming. We have to shop something. We have to purchase many things. Then he said, okay, no problem. He kept in the pocket and said, I will give you later on, not now. Next day, I found he's crying in tears. I said, what happened? He said, yesterday I was carrying that 5,000 rupees. I counted, I kept in my pocket, and that 5,000 rupees fall from my pocket. And I'm not able to find where I've like fallen those 5,000 notes. So just imagine, he gave to Krishna, and Krishna has given him the blessings. But now, because of his carefree attitude or whatever way, it's now not with him. 5,000 rupees creation is taken away. So what's better? Creation takes away or you give to Krishna? Everybody's responsibility in the temple to give something for Krishna. To give something for Krishna. Do not think the temple is only Krishna's place or few people's property. Prabhupada will arrange. We will enjoy outside. No. Everybody has to serve. That's the nature of a devotee. That whatever he earns, at least 10% out of his income, he serves to Krishna conscious temples. So this is how Prahlad was very happy. He was coronated as the king of the palace. And later on he enjoyed and served in the service of Sri Narad Muni. Regularly devotees used to come and he used to serve many, many devotees. So this is the Prahlad is teaching us that we need to be very, very determined on the path of Krishna consciousness. Problems will come. Nobody is killing us. Nobody is throwing us in the oceans. Nobody is putting us in the ocean ponds. Only we are married, no? Then what's the problem? marriage is not such a problem. And still people say, I can't chant because I'm married. Prabhuji, grihastha is a problem. I'm grihastha, charo kone pastha, I'm trastha. Not a problem. Marriage is not a problem. In grihastha, you can make grihastha as an ashram. Ashram means from where the sounds of the kirtan comes. That place is called ashram. If you go some hermitage, some yatras, you find Haridwar, Rishikesh, Vrindavan, Mayapur, Jagannath Puri. Kirtans are coming from the ashram. Difference between hotel and ashram, what's the difference? In ashram, there is a temple. In hotel, no temple. In ashram, there is food offered to the Lord. In hotel, food is not offered to the Lord. In ashram, if you stay, there's place to stay, place to sleep. In hotel, also place to sleep. In ashram, when you sleep in the morning, they will chant mantras and they will wake you up by kirtans. In hotel, they will give a tag, do not disturb, and you will sleep till 9 a.m. So what is better, hotel or ashram? Ashram to stay. So we have to make our home as a grihastha hotel or grihastha ashram. So what are the prerequisite of the grihastha ashram? A temple should be there, kirtan should be there, prasadam to bhoga to be offered to Krishna. Everybody should chant kirtans, and then the family becomes grihastha ashram. Otherwise it's a grihastha hotel. You have a good car, good everything, but no Krishna in your home, no kirtans, television is shouting like idiot box. That's what? That's the grihastha hotels. So very rare community have grihastha ashrams. Otherwise people use the word, I'm in a grihastha ashram, but that's not ashram, that's grihastha hotels. That's the grahamedis. Their sense gratification is the main prime concern. And later on when they die, nobody serves, nobody helps. They die on ventilators in the hospitals, investing lakhs of rupees. What is hard-earned money? They invest in hospitals, and after 20, 30, 50 lakh rupees of a hospital bill, they die in the ventilator. Nobody chants for them. It's better to give money to Krishna, and then Krishna will send devotees for you to chant at your last time. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Thank you so much, Hare Krishna. If you have any questions, we can take. Otherwise, we'll end up the class.